Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill John. It's Memorial Day in the United States, so I figure most people aren't at work today. I have a very, very obscure question that came in, but I love this question because it takes me back to the days long, long ago when I was a Cobol programmer. Back in the days of Cobol, they would store numbers in something called a packed format. Basically, it was hexadecimal. You could fit more numbers into a smaller amount of space back when disk space had a huge premium. There's a great function in Excel that will convert decimal numbers back to hex. So equal DEC 2, the number 2, HEX, and the number. And so I ran into someone at a seminar who said, look, we have a really old mainframe system. We have to take data from Excel. We have to upload it back to the mainframe. And so we're required to convert these numbers back to hex. But every once in a while, they said, the number doesn't show up on the mainframe. And what they finally figured out was it was all the low numbers, the numbers 15 and below, where there was only a single digit. The mainframe was expecting two digits, and basically they said, hey, we need to force this to be two digits. Well, my first reaction, and it seemed to work, was to use the text function. I want the text of that result in the 00 format. And sure enough, that worked great for the one, but I didn't think about the hexadecimal numbers from 10 to 15. Those are the numbers that basically are a single letter, A, B, C, D. And in this case, the double zero format doesn't work when there's a D in there. It's simply going to fail. So if we really have to do this, then the solution is to use equal right. And I'm going to concatenate a zero, an ampersand, and the result of my dec to hex formula, and so that I want the two most right characters. So what I get there is, for the single digit hexadecimal numbers, I'm now forcing a zero to appear. For the numbers that are already more than a single digit, so in other words, 19, 019, if I ask for the rightmost two digits from that, I'm getting the 19. So interesting problem there, sending data back up to a mainframe. Now, of course, for any COBOL programmers out there, or people that used to program in COBOL, if there's a negative, there's actually an overpunch on that last digit. The folks that I had talked to had gone through and actually figured out with some if statements how to change this dec to hex to change the last digit if, in fact, the number was negative. Very obscure question. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.